Hi, welcome to showmethecurry.com. I'm Hital.
I'm Anuja, and today we're going to show you how to make eggplant with garlic dip. And this is a recipe submitted by one of our viewers, Kanal. So thank you so much for this recipe. Mm-hmm. Very simple, let's get started. Mm-hmm.
It's a very innovative process, mm-hmm. actually. We have one large eggplant here, brinjal or aubergine or a lot of names for it, but basically it's a large eggplant. Mm-hmm. So we've washed it, and what we're going to do is just remove the stem from it, just chop it right off. And take off all this excess stuff. And then find a spot where it's stable, like this, where it doesn't roll around. And what we're gonna do is make four long slits along the top of this eggplant. You don't wanna make it go all the way through, but deep enough, because we're gonna be stuffing some things in here. So just gently make four slits. And you can gently open it up like so.
And one of the things we're going to stuff in there is green chilies, of course, to taste, and how much you want to put in, entirely up to you. So I'm going to start chopping these.
And the other ingredient is garlic, and lots of garlic, because after all, this is an eggplant and garlic dip. So we have about 10, 12, really as many as you like, and however big your eggplant is. We're just going to take whole cloves, and they're peeled, and we're just going to stuff them inside the slits, like so. And if they're really big, you can cut them down, but as long as they stuff inside, it's okay. Okay, so the eggplant is in.
It's stuffed.
It's stuffed.
Yep. And we're gonna also add in the green chilies.
Be careful handling the green chilies. If you're a contact lens wearer, use gloves.
Now, if you don't want it super spicy, you can leave them whole, and that way you can pull them out later. You just have the flavor without the actual heat. So we also have our oven preheated at 450 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's ready.
So now what we're going to do is take some aluminum foil. So place your eggplant on the foil.
So while Hetal pries it open, I'm going to just sprinkle a little bit of salt in there.
This is just a little to get it started. We can adjust it later.
And we're also going to put a little bit of olive oil in there.
And once all that's in there, we're gonna wrap the eggplant tightly with the foil.
So we also have a casserole over here, and we just make sure it's got some little bit of height so that in case any juices leak out, they're not all over the oven.
And this is gonna go into our dish and into the oven on the middle rack for 1 hour. So put it in and forget about it.
Mm-hmm. So our eggplant is out of the oven and it's hot. But we need to open it right away, so be very careful. Ooh, it looks so pretty. Mm-hmm. So you're gonna transfer it into the casserole.
And if you can hear that, you can see all the juices sizzling mm-hmm. in there. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna help absorb a lot of this juices, so you won't have a really watery dip. It'll be nice and thick.
Mm-hmm. And we're gonna take a knife and just slash it across a few times.
So if you have a potato masher, you can go ahead and just mash it lightly. This way all the whole garlic cloves get nice and incorporated into the dip, and so does the eggplant.
All this while that you're doing this, please be very careful. The casserole dish is hot, that the eggplant is hot, so just keep that in mind. Mm-hmm.
Now this is one of those roasted eggplant dips that we actually use the skin. I know a lot of times we roast yes. eggplant and we just peel it away and throw it away. But this is a fabulous way because we've got it covered all the time. It hasn't dried out, so it's right. still tender and it's still moist. But you do need to use that knife to kind of cut it across. If you have really big pieces of skin, just cut it through.
And I think it looks very pretty.
Yeah.
So I'm going to cut the skin down a little bit more, and then we're going to allow it to cool down.
So our eggplant dip has cooled down completely. It's room temperature now. Mm-hmm. And it's important to do that because the rest of the ingredients that we're going to add now, they need to be nice and fresh and crisp. And if you put them in really hot eggplant, it's going to cook it. So we don't want that to happen.
Yeah, it will wilt it. The cilantro definitely will get wilted, and the onions will get softened and you want the crunch. Mm-hmm. So this is 1/4 cup of onions that we've chopped fine. Now entirely up to you, you can add more or less, but this works for us. Here you go. 1/4 cup of cilantro chopped fine, salt to taste, and some lemon juice. We'll add a little at a time, you can always adjust later.
And just give that a good mix.
That looks so pretty. Mm-hmm. You know, eggplant by itself is not a very pretty color, especially after it gets cooked. So this, you know, the green and the cilantro and the red from the red onions, give it a little facelift.
So we kept adding a little bit of salt, a little bit of lemon juice until it was to our taste. Now this is a dip, so it needs to be a little on the sour side, a little on the salty side, just because it's a dip.
A little more intense. Mm-hmm.
A little intense, exactly. And it's perfect for us right now.
So here's the one way of serving it. You can serve it with crackers, with some pita chips, anywhere you like it. But you can go a step further as well. Here's another option. You can just add a little bit of sour cream to it. And voila, you have a creamy eggplant dip.
Right.
So,
yeah, healthy version, a little bit rich version, but fabulous either way.
True. Let's give it a shot. Let's give it a shot, both of them. Yummy. Yeah, you want to try this?
Yes. Yum.
I like them both. Really.
I do too. I mean, depends on what you're going for. If you're watching your, you know, weight, if you're watching your health calories wise, this is fabulous. It's practically, besides a little bit of olive oil we use, it's practically fat-free.
Right. And I love the way that you can still taste the onions, the crunch of the onions, you know, because the eggplant itself is so soft. So the onions provide such a great texture, and when you bite into it, they're still not as, you know, they've still got their crunch.
Yeah,
that's the reason
mushy.
Why we waited for the eggplant to cool down before we added the onions in. Which is really, really good. Yummy. Mm-hmm.
So this is a great dip if you're making it for 2 people or if you're making it for 50 people, mm-hmm. because there's hardly any extra work. You just wrap those eggplants up and bake them all at one time, and you can make this a day ahead, 2 days ahead, and it'll be fine to serve to your guests. So a great make ahead dip.
Right, and as we say for chutneys, the great inside sandwiches, and mm-hmm. I think this will be another great
one
sandwiches. So another delicious way of just, you know, having this.
So enjoy this delicious garlic eggplant dip and join us again on another episode of ShowMeTheCurry.com.
Adding a pinch of spice to your life.